Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question, and the question says that there is a production lot of 2520 fence pliers with hammer head and 30 pieces are packed per master carton. There are 84 master cartons in all. It is assumed that the cutters will be able to cut a 6 gauge, that is 4 millimeters diameter steel wire if their hardness is within 50 to 55 HRC Rockwell. What inference can be drawn for the entire production lot from the randomly selected samples? We know that in normal distribution, about 68% of the data or area lies between x bar minus sigma and x bar plus sigma. About 95% of data or area lies between x bar minus 2 sigma and x bar plus 2 sigma. And about 99% of data or area lies between x bar minus 3 sigma and x bar plus 3 sigma. Also, we know that proportion means a part considered in relation to a whole. And population proportion is the proportion of individuals in a population sharing a certain trait, and it is denoted by P. Similarly, sample proportion is the proportion of individuals in a sample sharing a certain trait and is denoted by P cap. Sample proportion is the estimate of sample proportion with x successes in n trials, that is, sample proportion p cap is equal to x upon n. Also, we know that formula to find population proportion p for 95% confidence interval is given by p cap minus 2 into square root of p cap into 1 minus p cap the whole upon n is less than p is less than p cap plus 2 into square root of p cap into 1 minus p cap the whole upon n, where p is the population proportion, p cap is sample proportion, and n is the size of the sample. With this key idea, we shall proceed to the solution. We are given a lot of 2520 fence pliers and 30 pieces are packed per master carton. There are 84 master cartons in all, so we randomly select say 40 pliers from different cartons and note the hardness of their cutters. Values came out to be as follows. Here we have hardness values in Rockwell from 40 randomly selected pliers. So here n is equal to 40, that is, the sample size n is given by 40. Now we shall calculate sample proportion of these 40 pliers. Now we are given in the question that the cutters will be able to cut a 6 gauge steel wire if their hardness is within 50 to 55 Rockwell. And from our sample, we know that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 pliers out of this range, and the rest 33 pliers have hardness values which are within the specified range. And from the key idea we know that sample proportion is the estimate of sample proportion with X successes in N trials, and sample proportion P cap is given by X upon N. Here, sample proportion denoted by P cap will be given by X upon N, that is, X is the number of successes, and here we have X as 33, as 33 pliers are within the specified range, and N is the sample size which is given by 40. So sample proportion P cap is given by 33 upon 40, which is equal to 0.825. We repeat the same process 9 times and calculate sample proportion for each of the sample lots. Reason for taking 10 lots is to get 10 values of sample proportion, thereby enabling us to safely assume that the values obtained form a normal curve. This also conveys that we have to inspect approximately 15% of the production lot. The values of sample proportion obtained from 9 other sample lots are as follows: 0.8, 0.825, 0.850, 0.825, 0.875, 0.850, 0.9, 0.875 and 0.925. Now we shall take out the mean of all these 10 sample proportion values, and it is equal to sum of all these values divided by 10, and this is given by 8.55 upon 10, and it is equal to 0.855. From the key idea we know that formula to find population proportion P for 95% confidence interval is given by P cap minus 2 into square root of P cap into 1 minus P cap the whole upon N is less than P is less than P cap plus 2 into square root of P cap into 1 minus P cap the whole upon N, where P is the population proportion, P cap is the sample proportion, and N is the size of the sample. We know that in normal distribution, 95% of the data lies between x bar minus 2 sigma and x bar plus 2 sigma. So we put the values of p cap and n in this formula to make an inference about population proportion, and here we have calculated the value of p cap as 0.855 and N is 40. Therefore, we get 0.855 minus 2 into square root of 0.855 into 1 minus 0.855 the whole upon 40 is less than P is less than 0.855 plus 2 into square root of 0.855 into 1 minus 0.855 the whole upon 40, which implies that 0.855 minus 2 into square root of 0.855 into 1 minus 0.855, that is 0.145, whole upon 40, is less than P, is less than 0.855, plus 2 into square root of 0.855 into 1 minus 0.855, that is 0.145, whole upon 40. This further implies that 0.855 minus 2 into square root of 0.855 into 0.145, that is 0.124 upon 40, is less than P, is less than 0.855, plus 2 into square root of 0.855 into 0.145, that is 0.124 upon 40. And this implies that 0.855 minus 2 into square root of 0.124 upon 40, that is 0.0031, is less than P, is less than 0.855, plus 2 into square root of 0.124 upon 40, that is 0.0031, which further implies 0.855 minus 2 into square root of 0.0031, that is 0.056, is less than P, is less than 0.855, plus 2 into square root of 0.0031, that is 0.056, which implies that 0.855 minus 2 into 0.056, that is 0.112, is less than P, is less than 0.855, plus 2 into 0.056, that is 0.112. This further implies that 0.855 minus of 0.112 is 0.743, is less than P, is less than 0.855 plus 0.112, that is 0.967. Thus we have got 0.743 is less than P, is less than 0.967. Now we need to work out the actual number of pieces which are fine. This is arrived at by multiplying the two end values of the population proportion obtained above by the size of the production lot. So we get 0.743 into 2520, which is the total size of the production lot, and this is equal to 1872.36, which is approximately equal to 1872, which is equal to 74.3% of the pliers, and we multiply 0.967 with 2520 and we get 2436.84, which is approximately equal to 2437, which is equal to 96.67% of the pliers. Thus we can say that the population proportion lies within the range of 0.743 to 0.967 in the 95% confidence interval. It means we are 95% confident that 1872 to 2437 pliers are of fine quality. It can be difficult to to take a decision regarding accepting or rejecting a production lot based on just this analysis as commitments, risk, validity of assumptions and other subjective factors are involved, quantitative analysis by itself is insufficient for decision making. Qualitative analysis is also required. However, based on the quantitative analysis done here, we are able to derive comfort in being 95% confident that 1872 to 2437 pliers are of fine quality, which is the required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.